Everyone, this is fun, and these are the studios I'm in, supporting them because I can, and please deserve for them, they're all amazing studios, and I love them all very much. If you want to sub to them, the links will be down below. Going on to why I made this video, the reason why I made this video is because I wanted to play Avatar Tag. I saw it on Lexi's video, I thought it'd be a fun idea, so here goes nothing, and see what happens. Question one is, if you were a bender, what menu I would have, and I would have water, because I love water in general, and also because you could use it for so many, use it for so many things. Healing, which I would love to heal people. On to question two, which is, favorite character in Avatar The Last Airbender. My favorite character in Avatar The Last Airbender is Ty Lee, because she's so energetic, so happy, and such amazing lookout. Life is kind of like mine is down. But she can do something that I can never do, which is flips and stand on her hands, and that's just so amazing that she can do that. And my other favorite is Suki. Suki is a Kanishi royal, and she's amazing. She also is tomboyish, like kind of like I am sometimes. And also one of my favorite main characters, which is Sokka. And I love all the main characters in that. And then first Airbender, I didn't really have a favorite out of them. I just love them all because they're all so amazing. Question 3. My favorite character in Legend of Korra is Jinora. I loved her the first time I saw her because she asked my question I have had for like the last year or two about Zuko's mother, which I wanted to know. I watched the commentary, I tried to figure out what happened to his mother, and she asked why away, and then of course I hated Ikki because she, or whatever, if she interrupts her, and then of course we never will find out. Hopefully soon we'll find out anyway. Her name is Ikki, whatever though. And my other favorite character is Balin, which I loved him because he's so funny. He's kind of like Sokka, but he has like a more happy outlook. He's a bit full of himself though, which I didn't really like that, but he gets better when he doesn't really is full of himself towards the middle of the series, so he's really awesome. Question 4 is who I would ship, which I didn't really know what shipping was until earlier this year. So, but I shipped, which of course they got together later, I shipped Suki and Sokka, which I love their characters. I loved when they got together finally, like somewhere towards the ending, latched up there somewhere. And then I also shipped Bolin and Katara, which I don't think they'll ever get together because stupid Mako. Okay, Mako's cute and all, but he's not that awesome. People stop going on and on and on. Mako's actually really, really mean because he cheated on Asami. You know, I guess he didn't really mean to, but he was second guessing the relationship with half of it. Katara decided to tell him that she liked him, even though she knew that he was liked or was with Asami. She should have tried to, probably should have waited, I know. It's not really how it went. But that's just the thing. And Asami, she's a wonderful person. She gave up everything, her family, her money, everything, to be part of Team Avatar, and that's just a lot of dedication that she didn't get back from Mako. On to question 5. Okay, who do you think Hoth's baby daddy should be? I think it should be Duke, because they seem too good together, I guess. They didn't have much competition together, but they seem good together, and they're both about the same size, I guess? I don't have much to say, because neither of them got Duke very little in there, and Toph didn't really talk to many people in a, no, like, I want to go out with you way for Sokka, but you know, she can't have Sokka in my opinion, because I love the Suki and Sokka good relationship there. So, I guess she'll just have to be with Duke then. I'm not really sure, I guess we'll find out soon though. Question number 6. We're halfway there, yay! Who is more scary, Amand or Ozai? I think Amand is more scary because, not because he does scarier things per se, because he's only taking away your bending, so that's not as scary as killing you like Ozai did, or wanted to. But Amand was scarier because he just scared Katara so much, and that just really terrified, at least terrified me, and probably a bunch of people too. And the mask was really cool because you had that air of wonder about who could he be, how, like, why did he become so evil, and why did he want to get rid of all the Bendels? And I guess I don't want anyone to ruin the ending, so I'm not going to tell what he did eventually, but he just was so scary, and yeah. Okay, question number 7. In the Avatar universe, who would you date? I would date, I think, Sokka, because he's so funny and he's also pretty much the only guy that I actually like in the Midwest. They have problems that way. So I would choose Sokka. And question number 8. Favorite animal companion, which one would you have? I would have Pablo, or the Fire Ferret one, because he's very cute and he can do a lot of cool stuff. He can do dances and all the cool things that Rocko taught him to do. I mean, not Rocko, and he's just very cool. Question number 9. My favorite avatar is Aang, because he's so energetic and he also seems to be very synonymous or enlightened at some points, and he seems also very able to determine things and be able to talk to spirits and also, you know, be the peacemaker between different races and different people, and the benders and the non-benders. And question number 10. Who is your least favorite character? My least favorite character is Jet, because he, of course, at first he leads Katara on, which is already kind of bad. And then he makes Katara and Aang do waterbending and make the smoke go into the air, I don't really know the whole thing, to make this, this dam fall down. And the dam, of course, falls down, but he's doing this not because he wants to liberate this village, like he says he does, because he wants to kill the whole entire village. And barely any of those people are benders or bio benders, none of them are really evil. So he's a really horrible guy. I don't really know why people specifically like him, because he lied and also he wanted to kill thousands of innocent people. Question number 11. Who has the best hair? I think it's Katara, because her hair is done through all the bunches of styles throughout the series, and it just looks so beautiful, and that's why I think it is. Question number 12. Got any pickup lines? I do not have any Avatar pickup lines. I am stealing some from the internet because I can't think of any. You must be a firebender because sparks fly when we touch. I'm an egoist, but I'd bend you over any day. Are you an egoist? Because baby, you are stunning. I may not be Berlin, but I am sure I can rock your world. Okay, that was not that much. Here's another awesome ticket line. It is, are you an airbender? Cause you, the wind beneath my wings. There's a lot of other cool ones. I did put this link below because there's so many cool ones here. And I have one more question I wanted to answer. The reason why I don't lose the edit with Avatar is because I've bought the series and I wanted to use the series I bought because, you know, I didn't want to steal it off the internet if I already bought it, you know, with my own money. It's kind of pointless. So I found out early over the seal that I could rip the DVDs, so that's why I'm using it now, but I guess I won't be coming out with any DVDs for Avatar until way later because I really don't know what songs for it to do yet, and I need to rewatch it so I know what I'm doing. And I guess have a great day. Bye, everyone. Bye. If you have any more questions for me to answer, because this video is really fun to do, please just send some questions over. Bye bye.